And the owner herself, Erin from Red Buffalo Coffee and Tea, we were just looking at your zero waste segment. Yes. So pretty amazing initiative. And that's been going on for how long now?
Over a year. June 8th last year is when we went and launched our official zero waste campaign that we've been doing. And it's been doing so well. I say we probably divert about 90 to 95% of all of our waste, either through recycling or through compost. And when you come in, people look around, they're like, where's your trash? And our trash cans are really these tiny little things that sit on the shelf, or tiny little things like saran wrap or those sort of. But they look at the cup and they go, well, where's your trash? Where do I throw this away? And you're like, well, this is all compostable. The lid, the sleeve, the cup, even That's the cold amazing. Version of it, it's all compostable. And we work with the Summit County Resource Allocation Park, which is up at the landfill, and they do our composting. So it's
cool.
Wonderful.
So cool. Now, I was also telling them that, especially this time of year, Erin, I was out over at Cataract Lake this weekend over by Green Mountain. Beautiful. But I saw my first aspen leaves changing, and it was like, no!
It's begun.
I'm not ready, but at the same time, it's one of my favorite times of year to go and get tea and coffee and warm up.
Well, you have
day.
A perfect tea for
yes,
fall.
Yes, tell
today.
Me about this one.
You had the cinnamon orange spice black tea today.
This is my one of my favorite teas of all time.
Yes, and I have one of our straight Darjeelings. We carry over 30 different varieties of loose leaf tea, and when I say loose leaf, I don't mean it's bigger particles in a prepackaged bag. It is loose leaf. It is there for you to sift, to smell. We sell it in bulk, and we steep it in an infuser basket. So it's a large basket. So the tea really gets a chance to breathe, and you really get a taste how loose leaf tea really should, I think. And it's still quick. So if you still want to be that in and out person, you got places to go, you know, people to see, then it's still just a wonderful way to experience tea.
Mm-hmm. And I have to tell you, I mean, the taste of it is just, it's so, there's so much more taste to it than what you get at the tea bag at
there's
the grocery store.
There's more body to it. Yeah. It doesn't get that burnt taste to it.
I mean, I tried for so long. I would go to the grocery store and be like, I'm going to be healthy. And
this sounds
looks
like a good flavor.
Yeah. And I'd bring it home and like every single time I'd just be like, I can't drink this. But totally different experience.
You
this.
Should come on in, taste a bunch of our teas. Oh, we have a wild blueberry green tea that's delicious. Mm. Like I said, we do have some straight single estate varieties. I have a Darjeeling, we have a Assam and Sencha's, and so it's really just you need to come in and taste these. But if you still need your super kick, we do you know, any espresso drink you like. We like to say, if you can think of it, we can make it. We have a fall seasonal drink started right now that I brought in last week, they might have seen, and that is our s'more latte.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
So
that sounds delicious.
Come on in and try our s'more latte, because it's fall. You might be camping. Well, it's not fall yet, but leaves are turning.
It's pretty
it's
much
getting
there.
Yeah. But if you feel like camping still, and it's just a wonderful taste.
And then, of course, you know, if people want to bring the kids in, you guys have things for them too.
We have gelato. We have kid favorite drinks. We have Italian sodas. We have milkshakes. Mm. So I shouldn't say that too loud to some kids because they might freak out. But we have Italian sodas. We have pastries, some breakfast burritos. But of course, a wonderful atmosphere too. You come on in, and as the leaves start to change too, we have some trees on our patio out back that'll do the changing as well. And it's just a beautiful time of year.
It really is. And especially this afternoon, like when we see the thunderstorms roll in too, these guys are still open.
Yes, 7 days a week.
Which is not necessarily the case with a lot of places, especially as we head into the fall season, things kind of really quiet down here in Summit County. So, but you guys keep consistent hours,
which
I love.
We will be 6:30 to 5:30, 7 days a week, now through mud season.
Love that.
So you can expect to find everything that you need. So
that's awesome. Awesome, awesome. Now, if people want to find out what you guys are up to, what's the best way?
Our website or our Facebook page. We update the Facebook page very regularly, so you can get a quick link to there from our website, redbuffalocafe.com. That's a picture. We were at the Pro Cycling Challenge. The intermediate sprint went right in front of Red Buffalo.
Awesome.
So that was really fun. We're a big cycling shop, family owned and operated, but the family, my dad was on the U.S. cycling team back in the 80s.
I didn't know that.
Come on in, chit chat bikes with all of us. We love it. I think all of us ride our bikes to work regularly, even in the winter.
Yeah, that is dedication. Yeah. That is dedication right there. All right, you guys, we'll stop on in. They're located right here in Silverthorne, and 6:30 to 5:30 every day.
Love that.
Try some of the cinnamon orange spice tea. It really is one of my favorites. We're going to take a break here in Summit Sunrise. We'll be back with more, so don't go away.